Guys, this is Rashmi Sinha and again welcome to my channel. A very warm welcome to all my well-wishers and my subscribers and my followers. So thank you very much for appreciation and giving the praiseness. So today I'm going to make this video for a special request of my very close friend because my friend is getting problem with the cleanliness, especially for the kids. So I am going to make a video on a cleanliness. So today I am going to give you the tips and tricks and hacks for cleanliness from tip to toe. So are you all ready to watch these tips and tricks? Yes, of course, yes na. So let's get started. So first and foremost thing is that habit of cleanliness is a routine. If you add it in your everyday's routine and everyone is following in the house, the child will definitely get to know. This is not so difficult. It is just a work to practice. It is not to teach, it's to practice. What we do, the smaller ones are doing because they're following us. So what I am going to say is that you have to establish the habit of cleanliness in the childhood. Then they are in their future, they will be a very managed and established person. If you want to make the children a very clean or managed or smart and in tidy, you have to follow these things. So let's start with the first thing, which is very early what we do first, which is brushing. I very oftenly get to know that many children are not brushing their teeth properly because they don't know how to brush the teeth, how much amount to take the paste on a toothbrush and how to apply it on a teeth. So this is your duty to teach them in a proper way. And please check the toothbrush must be changed in 2 months. It should not be continued for 6 months. Sometimes the brushes are okay. So what we do, we are keeping the same brush. So avoid this habit because they are not hygienic, unhygiene they are almost, and they are not good. So you must remove that toothbrush from the wardrobe or in the toilets. The second thing is the face cleaning. The children are not cleaning their eyelids and their nostrils and their lips corners. What they do, they simply throw the water on their face and just rub it by a towel. Towel is also very important. If you are cleaning the, you don't scold them, you don't argue with them because the facts they understand. So you just teach them that if you wash your eyes clearly, you have to drop the water on the eyes, you have to throw the water in this way, and you must clean your nose areas and the lips. What they will learn, this is the way my eyesight will be better. So this you teach them, and you check either are they doing or not, and use a very microfiber towels for the children because they have a very soft skin. So if we are using the very harsh towel or everyone is using in the family and that you're giving to the child, so simply they get the skin problems and as well as sometimes the eye puffiness or in the redness in the eye. Second thing you must watch before you are sending a child to the school, or if you are also being ready, you also can keep this in mind. Okay, third thing, what is the uniform? The very most important section, the uniform. Generally, children are having only two set of uniform. They are wearing and in a week they wash it and they wear 3 days and 3 days like this they do. This is also a very unhygienic idea. I suggest you do one thing. You keep three set of uniform at least and one new set of uniform for the special occasions. So these three set of uniform must be washed in every second day. And shirt and socks, please do not repeat them because shirt, collars and the handcuffs are getting dirty when the children are playing in the playground, and in a, what they are doing, they are keeping their hands on a bench or they are holding the staircases, they are holding window sills. So this area of the shirt becomes very dirty, and when they wear it next day again the same shirt, they are not looking smart. Everyone comes to know that they are repeating that shirt. So remove wash the shirt and socks every day. So you keep three set of shirt and socks. So that will be, because in a summers there is no problem, but in winters you need four set of uniforms, which is very important. And home clothes, teach them that how to keep the clothes. Generally what they do, the small things like socks and hankies and ribbons, and they usually lost it, and it is a great problem in a very 11th hour or in a last moment when the school buses are arrive or the time is, you have no time in the morning. So what to do? Teach them how to keep the socks. They can bind the socks pair, or they do what? They, one socks will be in the other socks. This is also the another way. By this, they will not lose their socks and they will also keep in this way. And teach them in a wardrobe how to keep the clothes. I am also standing just in front of my wardrobe. Here the clothes are kept in that way. I'll show you later. So teach them, so socks cabinets and the hanky cabinets and their rest, like the small things like hair bands or rubber bands, or they, that should be kept in other place. Don't mix all things together. It is very difficult for a child to find things in a hurry. So the fourth thing is what to say, lunch box and utensils. I saw it, and many of us maybe observed this, that the children are carrying the same lunch boxes every day, that is of made up of plastic, and the leakage, all the food is leaking in the bag sometimes, and they have a oily food. So what happens, the oil comes out from the lunch box and made their bags dirty. Sometimes their books and notebooks are also being dirty. So avoid sending these kind of lunch box to the school. Give them a very foolproof, waterproof, the proper leak sealed lunch boxes. You may buy the proper, you may buy the Borosil ones. They are of glassware. But if you teach the child to handle it in a childhood, they can handle in a future also. They are also smart. They understand the importance of the lunchbox. If the child is very naughty, they can't carry, then you can go for the fiber one, like the good quality, like Tupperware and all. They are also very good quality of. So you may use them. And you may use the steel boxes. Steel boxes and the glass boxes are the best, because they are not at all carrying any bacteria once you use. That is good for their health also. Water bottle also. They are very untidy outside. What they do, the bottles is dragged, or they are playing with them. So the bottles are torn and having a very patches on the bottle. That looks very untidy. So please buy that kind of bottle or lunch boxes which looks very neat and clean. And if they are not looking, don't go for that silly lunch box and bottle. That is of not so much costly. Please keep 3-4 sets that they can carry every day, different kind of lunch boxes. They are very crazy for lunch boxes. I saw the children are very showing their lunch boxes and pencil boxes to each other, and they're very happy when they bring new. So you may buy some set of lunch boxes, but don't buy the very cheapest one. Buy the better one. Okay, so this is also the very important thing which we keep in mind while sending the child to the school, because the school is 8 hours they are spending the 8 to 9 hours in the school. And if they are in this way, so what impact will go in their future? What they will teach their children, they will learn this, so they will teach the same thing. Next thing is notebooks and books, and the especially the bags, school bags, notebooks. If the notebooks are full, they are not in use, do not allow them to carry to school. They do not set their routine. They carry every book and copy, and make their chaos, their bags, that is not properly settled. So they are not able to find the books and copies in the school also, which also creates a very bad impact in the classroom. So what, please let them do check their things, and always say very normally and nicely to them that this is a bad habit they are developing. So if you do the same, they will also follow the same. So you must manage your things. So teach them, so do not carry any books and copies which is already full and no space to write. So please remove it from the bag and check what is the diary condition, what is their bags condition. Sometimes the bags chains are not working, and their bags are off their, all the books are kept in a one cabinet and rest are empty. So they, because they are small, they don't know how to do these things. If a child of class 8, 9, 10, I have seen, they are also doing the same, because they are not ever taught these things. So they don't think this is important in the life. But these things are very important. Do you believe Vastu? If you believe, this is also very important in Vastu. A managed person can only lead a very very precious life, or very successful life. So this is very important. So please keep eyes on their bags and their copies and books. Sometimes they they tear their books and they do not paste the pages. They are carrying the bags in that way only. So please, their books, they are carrying the torn books and torn copies, and sometimes they are very clumsy bags they are carrying, and they are holding, and teach them how to hold the bag also. What they do, they generally hold their bags till the hip area. They don't carry it to the shoulder, because shoulder can hold the bag. The bag should be holded by the shoulder. So teach them how to hold the bag on their shoulder. So by this way, they will learn. If in the childhood you teach them, there will be no problem in later classes, because afterwards when they are in class 9 and 10, they will definitely not listen you. So teach them in very childhood. If they are already in class 9, 10, slowly they will come to know that this is true. My parents are saying me true things. Next thing is study table and school benches. What I saw oftenly, they mess the study table. Lots of things are kept like a stationery shop, kept on the table, and they are making messy bench, school benches also. They do not allow the children to keep their things on the bench because they are very messy. They do it at home. They are doing the same thing in the house also. So please teach them how to keep things systematically on the table. Like pencils and tools are in the toolbox only, and the books and copies should be into the bag. Only the running books and copies which they are reading should be on the table. So teach them this also. So by this way, they will not create problem for others and as well as for themselves also. Next thing is games and sports article. Boys are having lots of sports things like the balls and the cock and badminton and skates and all. Many things you are buying for them. But they don't know where to keep these things in the house. So what they do? They just mess the house. They keep it under the sofa. They keep sometimes under the bed. And they are searching at the time of playing. So please make a cabin or a carton you can keep where they can keep their things, and please check before keeping is it clean or not, because they are going to play it again next day. Jo, next thing is that they must carry extra handkerchief, hankies or tissues or the rough newspapers, the old newspapers or sanitizers. You must keep in their bags. Sometimes what they do, they don't have any handkerchief and they don't get time to wash their hands. So what they do, they generally just rub their hands and just go on, and they carry a lot of bacteria and they get sick. So often you will find the children, those who are always being sick because of these reasons, because they are not at all hygienically conscious and they don't follow these things. So you must keep these things in their bag. This is your duty. This is not the children's duty, because they can't, well, later they will understand that these things are very important, so they will definitely follow. But please, you do it now. Next thing is skin dryness. What I saw, the children's skin, the most of the children, their skin is very dry, patchy, pigments, and this part is very dry. Some of them have oily skins. The children, the girl child having a oily skin, so they are having a pimples or acne on their face. So they are very small to handle these problems. So you do, please do one favor for them, that please buy a proper cosmetic, like a what face wash you are buying, and just give them milk, because inner health, what we in comes out. So if you eat good food, that comes out. Like they are not taking any dry fruit, they are not taking milk, they are not taking curd, they are not taking vegetables and fruits. So because of this, their skin is dry. But don't worry, you may buy some proper cosmetics to wash their face to keep it natural and baby look. Okay, so please children, you also keep in mind, so this is your very tender age. If you if your skin is dull now, what will happen later? So please keep it in mind. So buy proper face wash or creams, or if this is not going, please talk to the dermatologist. They will definitely tell you what is the remedy to use that. Next thing is extra safety pins. These small silly things are very, very difficult for the child sometimes when they are out or when they are in the school. Like extra safety pins or extra paper pins or extra hair pins. And if you have a girl child, please keep one sanitary pad in their bag that they cannot get any problem. And at least 20 rupees every day in their bag. Minimum 20 rupees. Do not give them so much money and do not give them so much stationery. stationery and do not give them so many bags that they are get so many things always create problems because they are not able to manage them. So buy little things and teach them how to keep it in a proper manner. Little things is easily managed, but so many things are messy. So for the girl child, please keep sanitary napkins. There is no shame in this. You all have seen the movies on them, okay? The last thing is hairs. Hair is a big problem. I saw the children are having a very dirty, dull, frizzy and mismanaged hair. And they don't tie it properly. They just come to school as if they just woke up and reached to school. So please keep their hairs in a proper manner. If they have a short hair, please make two ponies or a proper ponies. If they have a long hairs, just bind it, make a braid and settle it. And do oiling every week at least. Once or twice, as if you want, please do it. And if you have a boy child, they have also sometimes very dull hairs and their scalps are very dry and flaky, so please help them because they are so small to understand these things, but we people are mature to handle all those. Hope you all get my points very clearly, and definitely this video will help to take care of your child's cleanliness and hygiene. This is very important. And one more thing, the last thing, please keep dustbin in house also in their own rooms and teach them how to handle that, how to drop all things in the dustbin. Do not throw it in a school bags and do not throw it in a window sill and do not throw it in the corners of the bed. Please teach them to throw everything, whatever they found, please tell them to throw it in a dustbin to keep their house clean. And by this way, your all clutter problems will be solved and they will be very nice children. So children and parents, please follow these steps and these tricks to manage your child and keep them always healthy and hygiene. All the very best. Thank you. Bye-bye.